Okay, so I am here actually in Seoul, Korea. I happen to be at a professional conference where Eli Blevis is also attending, and Eli agreed to talk to me about his research on sustainability. Eli wrote the paper that you all will be reading, the 2007 paper, which won a Best Paper Award, so I'm really pleased that we're going to have this conversation. We're just going to talk in general about where Ellie thinks things are. So where do you think things are at, given where you were at when you wrote the 2007 paper? What's your
In
opinion?
HCI specifically, folks did a lot of work on individual behavioral change, things like home energy monitors. They were worried about how each individual person could save energy. And to this day, in fact, we see lots and lots of papers that are focused on individual behavioral change. More recently, this is actually because of Bonnie and some others, James Pierce, there's been notion of practice theory. The idea that actually we need to worry more about large-scale practices than individual behavioral change in order to have some kind of effect on how we can adapt to what's ahead, and also how we can possibly mitigate if there's any possibility of mitigation. But there's only so much as an individual we can do. And then we also, I suppose, need to worry about how we influence the practices of others. It's well and good to say that people need to reduce and consume less, and that they should take public transportation or alternative forms of energy and alternative forms of transportation. But the fact is, our luxuries, people like their luxuries, people like private places are a lot more comfortable than public places. They like their private cars. Cars are not just about transportation, they're some kind of statement about identity. And I suppose that it's a lot to expect that people will want to assume an identity as urban farmers rather than consumers of luxury. I think design is very is implicated in overconsumption. This has been true. If folks like Victor Papanek is famous for saying that there are a few professions more harmful than industrial design, but only a very few. And then he went on to say that design, and industrial design in particular, is about people consuming things they don't need with money they don't have to impress others who don't care.
That's pretty negative.
So that might be a Midwestern United States position. I guess that design needs to be about durability. And in that sense, digital technologies are the most insidious of all materials because they cause the premature destruction of physical materials. I'm guilty myself. I have a new laptop this year. I had a new one last year. It's just not made very well, and because I type a lot, I broke the backspace key on my
Oh, wow.
laptop.
And
And
you had
when
to replace the whole thing?
I went to try to replace the keyboard on my own, it was too impossible to do it, and I didn't have the time before coming here.
So
So,
that's bad design. It should be easy to replace that, right?
should be easy to replace, and anyhow, if you imagine, think about it, I really tried to live with it, in fact, because the metaphor of having a laptop that has no backspace key was kind of appealing to me.
You tried to make it work.
I guess so, but in the end, actually, you do kind of want to erase things. So yeah, I mean, that's fine. On the other hand, these glasses were made in the 1950s.
No kidding. Wow. You
And
just keep getting the lenses replaced?
right,
Fantastic.
yeah. So I think vintage things and durable things matter, and as designers, we could try to figure out how to make at least the material portions of our technology durable, even if the soft parts, the software parts will change. That was kind of the promise of software. In fact, it has the opposite effect.
Yeah. Right. So do you think that that comes from the fact that companies need to keep selling us new stuff to make money, or is there some fundamental attachment we have to always getting new things?
We like new things, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But they don't need to be new. They can be new to us.
Mm-hmm.
And so in the 2007 paper, I have something which I call the principle of quality and equality. And there the idea is that we should really only make things that are durable and of high quality. And then second, third, fourth owners will appreciate them and have an equality of experience. That's not always possible because technology obsoletes things, right? We want more and more capability, and we want less power consumption in the things that we hold, and more power. We want to watch streaming video, not something we would have thought we needed to do 10 years ago.
Right, right.
And all that takes energy. That becomes a much larger percentage of the world's energy. I think it already exceeds the airlines by a lot.
Yeah, right. So how can we sort of break through this cycle that we're in?
Well, so as on an individual level, I think that you can try to use less, or try to only buy things that are durable. If you like to have something new, try to find something old.
New to you.
That might be just as nice. That's just one personal strategy. Try to grow your own food. And try to, consume less. On a practices level, try to work with your, and by the way, this taxonomy of individual practice and policy is something I've gotten from Bonnie and her writing. At the practices level, you need to try to argue in your community and in your local community, especially, you need to try to set an example. That would be a good way. At the policy level, you need to be active also to try to influence policy so that both in terms of governance, so that we have leaders who are sensitive to this, but also in terms of enterprise too. You can help to find alternative economic models. Companies can have viable enterprise plans that focus more on services and less on material consumption.
Yeah, I think that's one of the key solutions myself, services.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's fine because services are luxury too.
Right, right, exactly. All right, well, let's end on a positive note with things that people can do and think more about. So thank you so much, Eli. That was really interesting.